We've all heard the story. In prehistoric times, males were the great hunters, while women remained behind to gather. This concept has long shaped our view of early human communities, but what if we've been getting everything wrong? In 2017, archaeologists working on Santa Rosa Island, part of California's Channel Islands, uncovered critical evidence surrounding prehistoric female hunters. During restoration work at Beechers Bay, artifacts such as Channel Island barbed points and crescent-shaped projectiles used for hunting birds and marine life were found. These findings, dating back over 10,000 years, suggest that women actively participated in hunting activities, challenging traditional gender roles in early North American societies. Today, we will look at revolutionary archaeological discoveries that are questioning the age-old story of man the hunter and those that support it. Let's unfold the startling evidence surrounding the truth about gender roles in prehistoric cultures and begin this heated debate. The idea of man the hunter first arose in the early 20th century, influenced by both archaeological and anthropological biases. This ideology typically positioned males as major providers via hunting, with women limited to harvesting plant staples. This perspective has permeated popular culture, especially the reconstructions of early human cultures, resulting in a mainstream depiction of male supremacy in hunting and survival. Why have we believed in man the hunter for so long? Why is it that not until recently have we started to think differently? Archaeological findings, such as stone tools and cut-marked bones, have affected this view due to being better preserved than plant-based artifacts like digging sticks or food leftovers. As a result, hunting evidence became increasingly prominent in the record, bolstering the belief that men's hunting was crucial for human existence. This idea was further reinforced by skewed ethnographic evidence, particularly from northern, meat-heavy civilizations like those in the Arctic. For example, early reports such as Viljarmar Stefansson's 1913 My Life with an Eskimo focused predominantly on male activities, reinforcing the narrative that hunting was central to these societies. Male roles in exploration and survival were also emphasized in Knud Rasmussen's 1921 Across Arctic America, native of the 5th Thule Expedition, greatly marginalizing women's contributions. Articles like these often overlook or underreport the vital roles women played in gathering and preparing food, leading to an incomplete understanding of the social dynamics in these cultures. Recent studies published in PLOS One in 2023 have recently altered the narrative, emphasizing women's involvement in hunting activities. Studies from foraging tribes, such as the Hadza of Tanzania, have shown that women not only gathered, but also hunted small wildlife, bringing significant nutritional benefits to their groups. The data defies previous beliefs and supports the concept that female hunting was not uncommon, but rather essential to survival, with women hunting alongside males, especially when children were handled communally. The Hadza's diet, which shifts between plant-based foods and meat, depending on the season, weakens the man the hunter theory, which overemphasizes the role of man in hunting for survival. Hadza's reliance on diverse food sources highlights the significant contribution of plant gathering, often by women, showing that early human diets were likely more balanced and not solely meat-centric. New evidence continues to emerge that calls into question the gender division of work in early human societies. And if the lives of our primate ancestors really interest you, be sure to subscribe. This intriguing conversation has only just begun. Recent archaeological finds have challenged long-held beliefs about gender distribution of labor in ancient cultures, particularly in terms of hunting activities. Traditionally, history has taught us that males were largely responsible for hunting big wildlife, while women collected herbs and cared for children. However, the next archaeological finds are changing the story. Archaeologist Randall Huss and his crew discovered a 9,000-year-old burial in the Andes that included the bones of a young lady with hunting gear, such as stone projectile points, suggesting that women also hunted large animals. Randy Huss and his colleagues published a crucial study in Science Advances in 2020 based on excavations at the Wilamaya Patay site in the Peruvian Andes. Their findings show that women played an important part in big game hunting some 9,000 years ago. Even more, the results from their study prompted a thorough analysis of 429 other graves from the Americas, which revealed that approximately 30 to 50% of big game hunters were female. Huss's findings directly undermine the classic assumption of male-exclusive hunting, highlighting the mobility of gender roles in ancient communities. Such discoveries are altering our understanding of male and female roles in ancient cultures and providing new avenues for investigating social dynamics in early human groups. However, this new perspective on female hunting is not without criticism. It challenges the strongly rooted man-the-hunter viewpoint, which holds that women are physiologically orientated to nurturing rather than hunting. In the year 2023, critics, such as anthropologist Vivek Venkataraman, say that although female hunting did occur, it was not as common as current research implies. He argues that the energy expenditure involved in hunting, particularly for large game, would have been more suited to males, who typically have greater muscle mass and endurance. And hunting required specific skills and knowledge that were often passed down through male kin networks. Venkataraman also argues that biological factors such as demands of pregnancy, breastfeeding, and childcare would have made it less likely for women to engage in hunting. He emphasizes that overinterpreting data may alter the allocation of work in ancient cultures by concentrating on outliers rather than normal tendencies. These comments stress the need to exercise care in data analysis when challenging long-held ideas in varied foraging cultures. But the widely accepted story of women remaining behind to care for children while men hunted is being challenged by the concept of alloparenting. We can look at relatively modern foraging cultures for information about how our ancestors lived, hunted, collected. Child-rearing behaviors in these communities indicates that childcare is primarily a community endeavor. The notion of alloparenting, in which people, other than the biological parents, assist in raising children, is highlighted in Crittenden's 2010 work based on a modern hunter-gatherer tribe known as the Akka people in Central Africa. His research shows that children are often reared within the wider society, with chores divided among extended family members and even non-relatives. This communal style of child rearing would have allowed women to hunt while their children were cared for by the community. According to Carr and Kramer's studies from 2010, ancient women most likely undertook varied roles that involved both hunting and parenting, undermining the strict dichotomy of hunter versus gatherer. And the adage, "it takes a village," seems to be true for many foraging civilizations, allowing for more gender flexibility. Gender bias is also an important topic in contemporary archaeological discourse. Scholars, such as Haas and others in 2020, have observed that projectile points recovered in male tombs are often identified as hunting equipment. However, comparable objects discovered with female bones are often rejected as symbolic or ceremonial, rather than practical instruments. These biases contribute to historical assessments that underestimate female hunters. An astonishing example of this bias occurred in Sweden. There is a Viking grave known as BJ581 that was originally excavated in the late 19th century and was long assumed to belong to a male warrior due to the presence of weapons and other grave goods associated with high-status warriors. This belief persisted for over 100 years until a groundbreaking DNA analysis in 2017 revealed that the skeleton was actually female. This discovery, led by Hedin Stierna Johnson and her team, challenged long-held assumptions and sparked a re-evaluation of gender roles in Viking society. And the role of females in early human communities is gaining attention. Aside from hunting, women participated in various tasks such as gathering, crafting, and even fighting. In 2022, research by Dr. Yonat Eshar challenges traditional views and concludes that women were not confined to domestic duties. Instead, they actively participated in gathering, which was a crucial survival task. A study by Professor Lucy in 2023, published in American Anthropologist, revealed that prehistoric women were involved in crafting tools and various community tasks, displaying a level of gender equality that defies previous assumptions about strict gender roles. While the man-the-hunter concept is not completely dead, it has been significantly challenged by anthropologists who advocate for a more complex view of ancient gender roles. New studies are substantially altering our understanding of human evolutionary history. As the debate continues, check out our other videos about human evolution. More interesting discoveries are recently disproving long-held beliefs of who we are and how we came to be.